I came in as the sun came up. She glared at me over her coffee cup. She said, "Where you been?" So I thought real hard and said, "I fell asleep in a hammock in New York." She said, "You don't know it, boy, but you just blew it." And I said, "Well, that's my story, and I'm sticking to it. That's my story. Oh, that's my story. Well, I ain't got a witness. I can't prove it, but that's my story, and I'm sticking to it." Got that deer in the headlight, looking through red my face like a cover of a book, and said, "Don't expect me to believe all that static, cause just last week I threw that hammock in the attic. My skin got so thin you could see right through it." And I told him, said, "Well, that's my story, man. Sticking to it. That's my story. Oh, that's my story. Yeah, I ain't got a witness and I can't prove it, but that's my story and I'm sticking to it." You know, the time comes when a wise man knows the best thing he could do. He's just look her in the eye and beg for mercy and face the bitter truth. But honey, me and the boys played cards all night. There was no hanky-panky, not a woman in sight. I should have called me, I'm really sorry, but I got a cellular phone and then you won't have to worry. You know how much I love you, darling, ready to prove it. That's my story, now sticking to it. That's my story. Oh, that's my story. Well, I ain't got a witness and you know I can't prove it. That's my story and I'm sticking to it. You know I ain't got to do a doggone thing, darling, unless you approve it. That's my story and I'm sticking to it.